WYFF News 4, live local breaking news at 6.
Good evening, I'm Carol Goldsmith.
And I'm Nigel Robertson in for Michael. First tonight, near record heat across our region.
News 4's Kim Quintero is here now with a look. And Kim, there's an ozone alert as well, right?
Yeah, that's right. Plus, we have severe storms. That's what we're going to talk about first, because that's the most dangerous right now. You can see from live Super Doppler 4HD, we have a severe thunderstorm that's bubbling up right along the Pickens and Greenville County line. We also have a strong thunderstorm that's working its way into Hart County of Northeast Georgia. We do have a severe thunderstorm warning that is in effect for Pickens, Anderson, and Greenville counties until 6:45 tonight. This cell's moving to the south at about 5 miles per hour. Also have another cell in Newberry County, a severe thunderstorm warning until 6:15. We still do have that heat, but where those showers and storms have moved through, we're seeing some relief. So it's coming at a price. 72 degrees right now in Franklin, 78 Nashville. On the flip side, it's 95 from Clemson through Anderson, 93 degrees in Greenville. And as you mentioned, we have bad air quality right now across the upstate, unhealthy for sensitive groups. We'll talk about what to expect for the rest of this week and when we'll see some relief coming up in just a bit.
Kim, thank you. The mom of a one-year-old killed in Greenville County is now charged in the case. You may recall this case. The woman's boyfriend, James Allen Johnson, was charged with homicide by child abuse. The baby girl died on May 27th. Deputies say the mother, Georgia Ann Sprouse, said one-year-old Nevaeh choked while trying to drink tea from a glass. But an autopsy showed the girl did not choke on a liquid, but instead was suffocated. Deputies have now arrested the mother and charged her with aiding and abetting child abuse and accessory after the fact. According to the incident report, the mother allowed her boyfriend to use excessive corporal punishment on her child, and that resulted in the eventual death of the girl. The mother, Georgia Ann Sprouse, is in jail tonight, being held without bond. Autopsy results were inconclusive on the woman found dead on a Union County riverbank. Investigators say the woman was 48-year-old Angela Millwood. They say she had been camping with her husband and two friends since the weekend. Deputies were called to the campsite along the Broad River yesterday afternoon. The sheriff says it's not clear how long Millwood was gone before her companions noticed. They're also not sure if health problems were factors in her death. The Union County Deputy Coroner tells us toxicology results are now needed since this morning's autopsy did not shed any light on the death.
Getting back to this extreme heat, whether you have flowers or vegetables, if you're trying to get your garden to grow, this weather is not making it very easy. News 4's Gabrielle Komorowski is live in our studios tonight to explain. Gabrielle.
And Nigel, I was supposed to be outside, but because of the severe weather Kim was just talking about just a few moments ago, I decided to come inside. But I brought a prop here with me because we are lucky enough to have some really pretty flowers outside of our studios at WYFF4, and I have to give the people who take care of these flowers some credit because, except for this one, they're looking pretty good. And getting flowers and plants to look this good has been a little more challenging this spring.
At the South Pleasantburg Nursery in Greenville, Davis Sanders has been doing this a lot lately.
We water, we water, we water.
So much water is needed because the weather has been so hot.
When the temperatures are this high, we normally have to water sometimes twice, even three times a day.
This mass is still built up.
At the National Weather Service office at the Greenville-Spartanburg Airport, Neil Dixon has been monitoring these unseasonably high temperatures.
Now they should be in the mid-80s, but we've been, you know, pretty commonly in the lower 90s to the mid-90s. And earlier this month, we tied the record, and it was in the upper 90s at 97.
He says the toasty temperatures aren't just causing problems for plants, they are also posing a health risk for some people by increasing the ozone levels on the ground.
People with different respiratory problems will have difficulty breathing.
Those people, he says, should stay inside, particularly during the afternoon and early evening hours. Not enough of this falling from the sky could cause greater problems in the future.
Most of the upstate now is being categorized in the abnormally dry, which is the first step into the drought.
So until it rains and cools off a bit, Davis Sanders and this hose will stay busy.
We're kind of like the plants. We don't like the hot weather either. So while they're suffering, we're also suffering trying to keep them alive.
Unfortunately, some places are receiving some rain tonight. And of course, while it certainly feels like summer outside, the first day of summer is not until June 21st. So looks like we have many more hot days like this one ahead of us. Nigel.
All right, Gabrielle, thank you very much. Deputies in Spartanburg County say a man stole electricity because of all this extreme heat, and it turns out he is not alone. According to an incident report, the man's power was shut off because he did not pay the bill. The man told deputies he tampered with his meter box to get it restored because of the heat and the fact that he has six people living in his home. He said he had to do it for his family. He was cited for larceny of electric current.
It's not safe, not only for the person that's doing it and then doesn't know what they're doing, but anybody that might come behind them.
Broad River Electric Cooperative says they've seen an increase in the power theft. That company and Duke Energy do offer extensions. They recommend you call your power company and ask for help if you end up in a bind.
Police say a man led them on a chase while driving a four-wheeler. Lawrence police say an officer on patrol at 5:20 this morning spotted the man coming out of the woods on a gator and swerving all over the road. A chase began and crossed several city streets before ending on Lisbon Road at Easy Road in the county. Police say an officer was bruised trying to grab the gator, and a county deputy vehicle was damaged when the gator backed into it. The driver of the vehicle, Thomas Grant Lynch, was arrested and charged with DUI and failure to stop. Warnings tonight from Greer Police: don't make yourself an easy target for thieves. That's because of an increase in car break-ins in Greer. News 4's Myra Ruiz has more.
Greer Police say they've seen a rise in car break-ins in part because people have made themselves easy targets.
If a criminal can't walk by and just visually see a camera or a laptop or a purse or any other expensive item just laying out, chances are they're going to move on to the next vehicle.
Police reports show these cars aren't always unlocked. Thieves have smashed through windows, picked locks, and pushed down windows left slightly open.
Even though the car's in the driveway, I leave nothing in it anymore. It's just too convenient for somebody to come grab whatever they want to out of your truck.
Someone broke into Brian Hayes' car while it was parked in his driveway as he slept. The thief took a list of expensive valuables, and now Hayes is warning others.
Take everything in the house with you, especially your garage door opener. I was lucky that they didn't open the garage door and get anything out of there.
Police say they're keeping track of where the crimes are happening.
We're going to have a lot more resources to hopefully deter this stuff from happening in the future.
Myra Ruiz reporting for us tonight, and police say most of the break-ins are happening on Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays.
Amazon is already posting job openings for its South Carolina plant in Lexington County. Legislators passed a tax break for the company, making Amazon exempt from collecting sales tax from South Carolina online shoppers until 2016. Governor Nikki Haley did not sign the bill, but said she would let the measure become law without her signature. The deadline was midnight Tuesday, so the Amazon deal is now complete. The company has now posted hundreds of job openings for the plant in Lexington County. There is a group wanting to open a new charter school in Greenville. It will be on Augusta Road, a part of town where development issues can get heated. News 4's Sean Mazzarello explains how the developer on this project opened the door for dialogue with people who live there.
The White's Mansion has been a fixture on Augusta Road in Greenville since the 1930s. You can tell it was an opulent home in its prime. Well, now there's an effort to turn it into a private school called the Chandler School. Scott Johnston is designing the layout.
The challenges are going to be more about integrating the school into the overall ground.
And Johnston knows he has to do that and preserve what's there. He led a tour of the building Wednesday morning for the Augusta Road Business Association. Members were told the private school would house K through 8th graders, would have limited enrollment to 10 children per class, and have a community garden, among other things. But what really got Kelly Odom on board with the project was what they said about keeping true to the original mansion.
I don't see how you could not be on board with it. It preserves the house. It's going to preserve the grounds.
Sean Mazzarello, WYFF News 4, Greenville.
The private school's investors have applied for a special exemption to the residential zoning. The appeal will be heard next Thursday by Greenville's Board of Zoning Appeals.
School's out for the summer. The sun is shining. Your children want to play outdoors, but how much is too much in this heat? Well, new at 6 tonight, News 4's Beth Brotherton with some advice from pediatricians on safe summer fun.
Let's see it.
At 7:30 in the morning, Jennifer Medlock has coffee cup in hand
to help me keep up with the children in the morning.
And her two kids on the playground. She gets them up and out early to beat the heat. And even this early in the day, she requires a sun hat and sunscreen.
We're lucky enough to have a DVR at home. I can DVR their favorite little educational cartoons in the morning. We watch them in the heat of the day after lunch when it's their downtime and get their energy out in the morning.
Jennifer's creativity is impressing pediatricians who say the worst thing you can do this summer is keep your kids indoors.
How hot is too hot to be outside? Well, as long as you keep two things in mind, you know, dehydration and blood sugar, then kids are, they're designed to be outside.
Pediatricians say keep an eye on your kids. Take frequent breaks.
One of the things we often recommend to moms is they set a timer, set your kitchen timer, set the timer on your phone, and frequently bring kids in for breaks. Not necessarily breaks from the sun, but breaks to get rehydrated.
While you're on break, it's a good time to reapply sunscreen and bug spray and try to get the kids to eat something.
I'm too hot to eat is what you hear in the summer, but then they need something with electrolytes.
Doctors say avoid juice. Sports drinks and water are best for hydration. They recommend ibuprofen for sunburn pain and Benadryl for bug bites. And of course, a healthy dose of creativity for prevention.
You guys ready to bike back home?
By 8:15, the Medlocks are ready to head back home, enjoying summer while avoiding the hazards of heat. Beth Brotherton, WYFF News 4.
The pediatrician Beth talked with has developed a fact sheet for parents on safe summer fun. It has really good practical advice on overheating, sunscreen use, treating bug bites and sunburns. And we have a link for you on WYFF4.com. And while you're on our website, we'd love to see photos of the ways you and your children are staying cool. Just upload those candids of your little swimmers and popsicle eaters to the Beat the Heat section of U Local.
Sunscreen, avoid juice.
Yep,
I'm still taking
down
notes on all of that because it is hot out there.
And it's going to stay that way, isn't it?
It certainly is, but we're beating the heat right now with some severe weather as those thunderstorms move through, certainly cooling down our temperatures. This is a live look from our Greenville SkyCam. You can see some very gray skies. We've been able to catch a couple of strikes of lightning from a severe thunderstorm that is just to the west of us, right around Easley along the Pickens-Greenville County line. And this system is going to be around for at least a while. You can see it's actually strengthening with that red, the magenta. This cell is actually capable of producing half dollar size hail, certainly heavy rain, cloud to ground lightning, and winds in excess of 60 miles per hour, and it is nearly stationary over this area. You can see this warning is in effect. We had one that was in effect in Newberry County that expired. This one right now goes until 6:45, but it may be extended as needed. As that storm gets closer to us, it is certainly cooling down Greenville. It is 87 degrees right now. It cooled down Clemson significantly, 89 degrees. It's still hot in Anderson, though, 93, and cool across western North Carolina, where they too had some severe thunderstorms. We're talking about the low to mid 70s right now. The humidity is on the rise as those storms start to bubble up. These are pulse thunderstorms, and that humidity is going to stay with us once again tomorrow afternoon for the return threat of scattered to isolated showers and storms. Today's high in Greenville was 95 degrees. It's not supposed to be this hot this time of year, I'm sorry to say. Our normal high is 84. Asheville, you are in the 90s club today. 91 degrees, the normal for this time of year is 79. And I can tell you, we don't have any 70s in the forecast anytime soon. You can see from our southeast satellite radar picture, we do have those showers and storms that are firing up across our mountains, spilling into the upstate. This is all along an upper level ridge of high pressure that's been with us for weeks now. That high pressure is trapped in hot, humid, stagnant air at the surface. And as we get into the heat of our day, that's when we see those storms start to bubble up. You can see as we head into Thursday afternoon, we've got a repeat performance of this. And we have those showers and storms that start to fire up across western North Carolina first, then spill into the upstate. Once we get to sunset and we lose the heat of our day, that's when we see these showers and storms start to dissipate. Then as we head into Friday, more coverage of showers and storms in the afternoon, just before a cold front starts to get its way towards us. Okay, quick check of the tropics. This is our first named storm of the 2011 hurricane season. This is a tropical storm Adrian. It's over the eastern Pacific. Right now it has wind sustained at about 70 miles per hour. It's moving to the northwest at a snail's pace at about 7 miles per hour. Doesn't look like it's going to impact land. Doesn't look like it's going to make landfall over Mexico, but you will notice some rough surf in those areas if you're vacationing there maybe over the next couple of days. Your air quality for tomorrow, again, unhealthy across the upstate. So if you have respiratory problems, you want to stay indoors from the hours of 6 a.m. till 9 p.m. I know, easier said than done, right? Temperatures tonight, 62 to 72 degrees. Those storms will end as sun starts to set. 88 tomorrow in the mountains with a high of 94 in the upstate. Plenty of sunshine to start the day and then showers and storms in the afternoon. That's going to be the story as we head off into the weekend. But you can see we will have some relief. Once a cold front moves through on Saturday and Sunday, we'll have a drier air mass. Our temperatures are going to cool just a couple of degrees, but then ramp back up for the start of our next work week.
Thank you, I guess.
That was a lot in a smorgasbord of weather.
There you go.